Hello dear students, in this video I am going to discuss some multiple choice questions on organisms and populations, which is the topic in second PUC in the ecology part. So let us move to the brief theory revision, then I will move to the questions. So ecology is the branch of science that studies relationship between organism and their physical and biological environment. So here in the image you can see the different organization levels of ecology, such as organism, population, community, ecosystem, and finally the biosphere. Depending on annual variations in the intensity and duration of temperature and precipitation, both the factors are responsible for the formation of major biomes such as Arctic, conifer, temperate, grassland, tropical, and desert. So these are the major biomes which are classified on the basis of annual variations in the intensity and duration of temperature along with precipitation. The organisms are affected by major abiotic factors such as temperature, water, light, and soil. Few organisms can tolerate wide range of temperatures. They are called eurythermal organisms, and some organisms can tolerate narrow range of temperature. They are called stenothermal organisms. Similarly, the two terms eurihalin and stenohalin, the organisms which can tolerate wide range of salinity, they are eurihalin, and the organisms which can tolerate narrow range of salinity are called stenohalin. So these terms are given to the organisms with reference to their tolerating ability for temperature as well as the salinity of the water. Organisms show different responses to the environment. Some of them are regulators, some of them are confirmers, and some show migration, and one more response shown by the organisms is suspension or suspend. The organisms which regulate, they maintain the constant body temperature through the homeostasis. What is this homeostasis? The ability of an organism to maintain constant internal environment is called homeostasis, and this is shown by warm-blooded animals or warm-blooded organisms. They are called regulators as they maintain constant body temperature and osmotic concentration. Majority of plants and animals, they are confirmers. The cold-blooded animals and all the plants are confirmers. That means they cannot maintain a constant internal environment, because the confirmers don't have the ability to show homeostasis, so that they cannot maintain constant internal environment. And such organisms, they go on changing their body temperature according to ambient temperature. That means according to the surrounding environmental temperature, these organisms maintain their body temperature. Here in these organisms, thermoregulation is expensive process. Maintenance of the body temperature is expensive process, and even they show the osmoregulation. They maintain the body fluid, constant maintenance of the body fluid according to the ambient water. So surrounding temperature and surrounding water are the deciding factors for the maintenance of water and temperature in the body of these organisms, which are called confirmers, and the response shown by them is called confirmation. Then one more very interesting type of response is migration. Organisms show temporary long distance movement because of stressful conditions from one habitat to another habitat. It is called migration. The organisms which cannot undergo the migration, usually they go for suspension, and in the suspension the metabolic functions are temporarily stopped during stressful period. If the environmental conditions are unfavorable, the organisms show temporary stop signal for the metabolic functions, and this represents suspend. And the different types of suspended activities are hibernation, estivation, diapause, as well as dormancy. Hibernation, it is called winter sleep. To avoid the winter, to avoid the stress created during the winter, some organisms, they become inactive. For example, polar bear, frogs and lizard. So this is hibernation. Similarly, to avoid the stress of summer, the summer sleep is called estivation. During the summer, all these activities are stopped. For example, snails and fishes. Diapause, the stage of suspended development. It is seen in many zooplanktons to avoid the unfavorable conditions. So by all these mechanisms, the organisms tend to survive in their surrounding environment, either by regulating the process or by confirming, showing the migration, or by undergoing suspended process. So these are the responses shown by the organisms to the surrounding environment. So here you can see the same explanation in the form of graphical representation. Then adaptation, very interesting phenomenon shown by the organisms, because without adaptation, organism cannot survive in its surrounding environment. And during adaptation, some changes occur in the body. They may be morphological changes, it includes physiological changes and as well as behavioral changes. To adjust with the surrounding environment, to live in the same environment, organisms always show changes in their morphology, changes in their physiology, and changes in their behavior. And all these changes make possible to organism, it can survive in the same environment. Not only survivalence, even these changes are helping the organisms to undergo reproduction in its original habitat. The some examples, like the adaptation observed in desert animal, particularly the kangaroo rat. So this kangaroo rat is living in desert of North America. It never drink the water, and to fulfill the requirement of water in its body, it is carrying out fat oxidation. What is the relation between water requirement and fat oxidation? In fat oxidation, water is the byproduct, and through the fat oxidation mechanism, it fulfills its water requirement, and to conserve the water in its body, the kangaroo rat is producing concentrated urine so that very very minimal volume of the water is lost during the excretion. It don't contain sweat glands. All these adaptations are helping kangaroo rat to live in the desert of North America. Similarly, one more example, desert lizard. It is also living in desert. To keep their body temperature constant, it shows behavioral adaptation. In kangaroo rat, we have seen the physiological adaptation, because fat oxidation, production of concentrated urine, absence of the sweat gland, there will be no production of the sweat. All these are the physiological processes. Through these physiological processes, the kangaroo rat is living. By adopting these physiological changes, the kangaroo rat is living in the North American desert. Like that, desert lizards show behavioral adaptation. So when body temperature decreases, it exposes its body to the sun. Again, the temperature becomes normal or matching with the surrounding environment. If body temperature increases above the comfort zone, then in the desert the lizard hides its body. Burrowing habit is also helped to protect desert animal from high temperature. So this is behavioral adaptation observed in the desert lizard. Similarly, organisms surviving in the cold climate, they have short ears and short limbs. This helps in minimizing the heat loss, which is called Allen's rule. For example, the polar bear. Apart from that, the mammals or the aquatic animals living in cold water, they contain a thick layer of fat below the skin known as blubber, and that blubber acts as insulator because it absorbs the heat as well as minimizes the heat loss. The humans who are living in higher altitude, they have more number of RBCs in comparison with the humans living in plain area. Like this, organisms are showing one or another type of adaptations which may be related to morphology, physiology or behavior, and finally that enables the organism to survive and to reproduce in its habitat. So here the images of kangaroo rat, desert plant, which is showing again maximum adaptations to survive in the desert or xeric habitat. Leaves are modified into spine so that it can reduce the rate of transpiration and loss of water. Stomata remain closed during the daytime. They show the CAM pathway, crassulation acid metabolism. The leaves are covered by thick waxy cuticle. All these adaptations are mainly to prevent the loss of water during transpiration, so that cactus-like plants are able to survive in the xeric condition or in the desert area. So here it is desert lizard and animal with small ear in cold climate. So these are some examples with respect to adaptations. Then population attributes. Population is a group of the individuals living in a particular geographical area, and population attribute are the birth rate, death rate, sex ratio and population density. A population at any given time is composed of individuals of three different age groups according to the ecological description The population is of three different age groups, such as pre-reproductive, that means who have not attained the reproduction maturity, reproductive, who have attained the ability to undergo sexual reproduction, post-reproductive, the individual group of individuals who have lost the ability, that means they are in the stage of aging or senescence. By considering these age groups, if the pyramid is plotted for any population, it represents age pyramid. Depending on the number of individuals in pre-reproductive, reproductive and post-reproductive age groups, the age pyramids can be described in three different models, such as expanding, stable and declining. In expanding, number of individuals are more in the pre-reproductive age group than that of reproductive age group and post-reproductive age group. In case of stable, the number of individuals are same in pre-reproductive and reproductive age group. In case of declining, number of individuals are less in the pre-reproductive age group than that of reproductive age group. So these are the three types of age pyramids classified on the basis of number of individuals in three age groups, such as pre-reproductive, reproductive and post-reproductive. Here is the population growth. The population size changes depending upon time and factors like food availability, weather and predator pressure. Even competition also affects the population growth. And population density in a given habitat during a given period of time changes due to four important factors, such as natality, number of births per 1000 individuals of a population at a given period of time, it is B, and mortality, number of deaths per 1000 individuals of a population in a given period of time, it is mortality, immigration and emigration. The migration or movement of the same kind of the species from one habitat to another habitat. The addition represents immigration and the movement represents emigration. Here, natality and immigration have got positive effect on the population density N, because both of them are responsible for increasing of population density. Mortality and emigration, they have negative effect on the population density, because both the factors are decreasing population density. So this is the representation for factors that affect the population density. Then population growth models. The population growth is explained by two different models. One is exponential growth model. When the resources availability is unlimited in the habitat, the population grows in an exponential or geometric fashion, which is represented by dN by dt is equal to b minus d by n. When population shows exponential growth, the curve plotted will be in relation to time and assumes J shape. That means continuous increase in the population, provided if the resource availability in that habitat is unlimited, represented by the formula dN by dt is equal to rn. The b minus d can be considered as r, so that it is represented as dN by dt is equal to rn. Then one more model, logistic growth model. No population can continue to grow exponentially, that means continuously increasing, as the resources availability become limited at certain point of time. It is true, and it is described by the equation dN by dt is equal to rn divided rn into the bracket k minus n divided by k. where N represents population density at a given time, R is the intrinsic rate of natural resources, and K is the carrying capacity. According to this model, carrying capacity decides whether the population growth is increasing or it is decreasing, and in the logistic growth, the plotted curve will be of S shape. Exponential growth, J shape. Logistic growth, it is S shape. So here is population interactions. The living organisms always interact in various ways to form biological communities. Interspecific interactions, it is the interaction of population of two different species. Intraspecific interaction, it is the interaction of individuals of the same species, and this interaction may be for food, shelter, protection and reproduction. And following are the types of population interactions. Mutualism, where both the interacting species are mutually benefited from each other. That is why the plus sign is given for species A and species B with respect to mutualism. Say for example, the flower is pollinated by honeybees. So flower is benefited from honeybee. In turn, the flower provides nectar and pollen to the honeybees. That means honeybee is also getting benefit from the flower. If both the interacting species are benefited, that kind of the interaction is called mutualism. Competition, always observed between two almost equal species, where the interacting species, one is competitively superior and another is competitively inferior. Not only the term inferior, competitively inferior. And competition results in loss of the biodiversity. If competitively inferior individual is by chance removed, it is the loss to biodiversity. That is why there is the risk of removal for the both the species who are interacting in the competition. Then predation, the kind of the interaction observed between prey and predator. Predator is the strong species and prey is the weaker species. Always here benefit is for predator. Parasitism, the interaction observed between host and parasite. Host is the organism which is providing all the basic requirements to the parasite, and parasite is the organism which is dependent on the host, getting benefits from the host but in turn harming the host. So in parasitism, the parasite is always benefited. Commensalism, kind of the interaction between two species where one is benefited, another is neither benefited nor harmed. For example, barnacles growing on the back of whale and shark, where the barnacles are carried by the animal for long distance, whereas the animal fish is not affected. So barnacle is getting benefited but whale is not benefited, and neither benefited nor harmed. It is commensalism. One more same kind of example, egret birds in vicinity to the grazing animal. So when animal grazes, it rushes its head into the plant where it is grazing. So when the grazing animal rush into the plant, the insects come out, and those insects are caught and eaten by the egret birds. So egret bird is getting benefited from the grazing cattle, and this is neither giving benefit to the cattle nor harming. Then amensalism, here also the two species are interacting with each other where one is harmed and another neither benefited nor harmed. the bacteria growing near a mold. If the bacteria is growing near the penicillium mold, the chemical secreted from the penicillium kills bacteria, but it don't have any intention to kill that bacteria. So here bacteria is harmed and penicillium neither benefited nor harmed. So these are the different types of population interactions. So this is the brief revision of topic organisms and population. Now move to the questions for competitive exams. So let us go for the first one. Which of the following is the stage of suspended development? When the term is suspended development, temporarily alle growth and development stop agirthada due to unfavorable conditions of environment. That is why the term is suspended development, and it is called the physical state of dormancy in response to environmental conditions. Suspended development, the correct answer for this question is option D, and it is diapause, because diapause is a condition of suspended activity where the growth and development are suspended. So very important point to remember, the diapause in the organisms is regulated by, particularly in animals, is regulated by three types of hormones. So here I have mentioned, one is juvenile hormone, another is the diapause hormone, juvenile hormone, and one more is diapause hormone, DH, and last one is prothoracicotrophic hormone, PTTH, prothoracicotrophic hormone. These are the hormones in animals which are regulating the diapause during unfavorable conditions of the environment where growth and development, both the processes are suspended. Then, second one, the age of pyramid with narrow base indicates, yes, age of the pyramid plot madara, but other the base ena agaiti narrow agaida saanadada. So what it shows, when base of the pyramid is narrow, it shows the low number of young individuals. Option B is the right answer for this question. Yake, the age pyramid with narrow base indicates low number of young individuals, and this is showing the birth rate is drastically reduced. If young individuals means number of individuals in the pre-reproductive age group, when pre-reproductive age group is diminishing, andra alle number of individuals kadime aglikattidra edakka compare madidre, in comparison to the other groups like reproductive and post-reproductive, it results in urn shaped pyramid. That means narrow at the base and broader at the successive step. Andra mele athwa madhyabhagadolaga salpa jaasti expand agiddu, adra the base matra sannadagidre adanna urn shape anta karitara. Like flower vase, flower vase ge madhyak agalirtade, expanded da kelag narrow agirtade. That is the urn shape, and this kind of pyramid indicates that population is dying off. Adanna young population anta kariyudilla, old population anta karitara, because number of individuals are less in the pre-reproductive age group. So B is the answer. Then read the following statements and answer the question. Idrolog nav yen identify madbeku, how many above statements are incorrect. Which are the statements incorrect with respect to this question? Temperature progressively decreases from pole to equator. Is it possible? From pole to equator, actually temperature increases. That is why the polar regions are characterized by low temperature. Our intestine is a unique habitat for hundreds of species of microbes. Yes, this can be given as an example for mutualism, where the intestine is providing the space and in turn we are getting the absorption facilities with the help of microbes. Average temperature exceeds 100 degrees Celsius in thermal springs and hydrothermal vents, high temperated area. In polar areas, the high altitude temperature goes up to 70 degrees Celsius. Temperature goes to more than 50 degrees Celsius in a tropical desert in summer. So that is also true. So what are the wrong statements? See, in polar area, high altitudes, temperature goes to 70 degrees. The temperature ranges from sub-zero level in the polar zone. So the wrong statements here are option B is the answer, where the first and fourth one are the wrong statements with respect to given statements. Yes, make the correct statement. Many fishes thrive in Antarctic water where the temperature is always below zero. So what is this example? Aquatic animal surviving in cold climate. How it is made possible? Because of the presence of insulating structure, that is blubber. Microbe can survive in hot springs where the temperature exceeds 100 degree. Yes, bacteria are surviving in the high temperature thermoacidophils. Fishes can survive even at a depth where pressure exceeds 100 atm. So pressure 100 atm, benthic organisms are there. Desert lizards have a marvelous physiological ability to survive scorching heat of the desert. This is the incorrect statement, because desert lizards, they lack the physiological ability to survive in the heat of desert. They lack physiological ability. Andra physiological process lane temperature na maintain madu ability desert lizard illa. Mathe en maadtada? But it is able to maintain its body temperature through the behavioral activity. Idrolaga physiological adaptation nodangla naavu. The desert lizard is showing behavioral adaptation, because when body temperature drops below the comfort zone, adu tanna body na sun ige expose maadtada, matte temperature comfort zone ige bartada. Yavaga body temperature comfort zone kinta mel hogtada, it hides in a burrow. Adu sand olaga burrow maadkondu alli tanna body na hide maadtada. This is not the physiological ability, this is behavioral capacity, where the desert lizard is adjusted with the desert heat and environment. So desert lizard don't have the physiological ability, but it is showing behavioral adaptations. Then assertion and reasoning. Predation is a type of interspecific interaction with a strategy based on feeding. Yes, always it is found between maximum the different types of species. A stable population is maintained through the time by the populations of predator and their prey, and are rarely one population becomes abundant or scarce. What is this? ಈ ಪ್ರಿಡೇಟರ್ಗಳು ಪ್ರೇಗಳನ್ನು ತಿನ್ನೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಈ ಪ್ರೇದ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ನು ಒಂದು ರೀತಿ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟಂಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೈ ದ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಎಕೋ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ಡ್. ಎಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರಿಡೇಟರ್ಸು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟಿಂಕ್ಟ್ ಆದರೆ ಅಥವಾ ಅದ್ರ ನಂಬರ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆದರೆ ಪ್ರೇಸದ ನಂಬರ್ ಏನಾಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ, ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಇಂಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಎಕೋ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ both assertion and reason are the correct statements, and reason is the correct explanation of assertion. One more, species are group of potentially interbreeding natural populations which are isolated from other such groups. So very simple definition of the species, potentially interbreeding. That means the individuals must have the ability to undergo fertilization and reproduction, isolated from other groups. The morphology and behavior of the species is different from one group to another group, individuals in one species and individuals in another species. Distinctive morphological characters are displayed due to reproductive isolation. Here the reason given is also correct. Reproductive isolation is responsible for the displayed morphological characters. Individually, assertion and reason both are the correct statements, but reason is not the correct explanation of assertion. Then, the benthic organisms ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಇರ್ತಾವ? The benthic organisms live near the sea bottom, found in open water, always live at a depth of 50 to 100 meters, live outside the water. Benthic means bottom dwelling. The organisms which are surviving in the bottom, live in the bottom, they are called benthic organisms. For example, sponges and some crabs, they are dwelling in the bottom of sea, they are called benthic organisms. Next, which one of the following is categorized as a parasite in a true sense? So in the given statements, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟದ್ದು ನಾಲ್ಕು ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಯಾವುದನ್ನ ಟ್ರೂ ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಅಕ್ಯುರೇಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀಬಹುದು? ಸೊ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಒನ್ ಎ, ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಫೀಟಸ್ ಡೆವಲಪಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ದ ಯುಟರಸ್ ಡ್ರಾಸ್ nourishment from the mother, is it completely parasitic? The female Anopheles bites and sucks the blood from humans. Head lives living on the human scalp as well as laying eggs on the human hair. The cuckoo, koel, lays its egg in crow's nest. This is example for brood parasitism. So what is this real meaning of parasite? Getting shelter, getting protection, getting food, and getting space for reproduction. ಈ ನಾಲ್ಕು ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ಗಳಿಗೆ ಒಂದು ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮು ಒಂದು ಹೋಸ್ಟ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ ಆಗಿದ್ರೆ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟ್ರೂ ಸೆನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ವಿಚ್ ಒನ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಹಿಯರ್? ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೆಡ್ ಲೂಸ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಸ್ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಪ್ ಆಸ್ ಲೇ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಎಗ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಹೇರ್. It is getting the place, it gets nourishment from the scalp, even it is undergoing reproduction. So C is the answer. Then moving to next question, which of the following is an incorrect statement? The human liver fluke depends on two intermediate hosts to complete its life cycle. Yes, it is right. Malarial parasite needs vector mosquito to spread to other host, female Anopheles mosquito. Parasites that feed on external surface on the host organisms are called endoparasites. Cuscuta derives its nutrition from the host plant, which is a parasite. Yes, cuscuta reflexa, it is the parasitic plant with hostoria where it sucks the food from other plant, so it is parasitic plant. Here the option C is wrong statement, because parasites that feed on external surface of the host, they are called ectoparasites, not endoparasite. Endoparasite directly enters into the body of host, but endoparasites are entering into the host body. Ectoparasites are remaining on the surface of the host organism and they suck the food. So C is the answer. So here the match the following. Predation, it is the cactus and moth. Commensalism, one is benefited, another neither benefited nor harmed. Orchid and mango tree, orchid is epiphyte growing on the mango tree. It is getting the space to grow, but because of orchid growth, mango tree is neither benefited nor harmed. Parasitism, cuscuta reflexa and hedge plant. Then competition, it is balanus and cathamalus. So which one is the answer? So A is right option. Let us check. A, option third. B, it is fourth. C, one. And D is second. So option A is the right answer. Next, very small animals are rarely found in polar regions because polar region olaga bahalashtu sanna pranigalu nodlikke jaasti kaanalla yaaka, because they have a large surface area relative to their volume. So this is the answer. Why the small animals are rarely found in the polar region? This is the reason. They have large surface area in relation to their volume. So polar zone olige en irthada, first of all temperature is low. Temperature outside cold iddaga internal temperature na maintain madlikke ee organisms jaasti energy na expend madtava, and body heat through the metabolism. Metabolic activity na use madkondu body heat na generate madaka jaasti energy na use madkotava, because their surface area is larger than their volume, in relation to their volume. So that small animals are rarely found in the polar region. So population ecology is an important area of ecology because the given options are, it determines the interaction among organisms and between the organisms and its physical environment, which is the definition of ecology. Evolutionary changes through natural selection takes place at the population level. It links ecology to population genetics and evolution. It links different types of communities together. First, what is this population ecology? It is the branch of ecology that studies structure and dynamics of population and population area. It is an important because it is linking the ecology to population genetics and evolution. Population ecology, population genetics na evolution jothege link maadutada, so that the line of evolution can be traced. Hangagi population ecology is an important area. Then, to a large extent, vegetation in any area is determined by vegetation, the group of the plants growing in that area. How it is determined? The answer is pH, mineral composition and topography. Here the option C is right answer, because the pH of the soil is important. What is the quantity of mineral nutrition available, and topography, the natural and artificial physical features of an area. All these are important with respect to vegetation of a particular area. The two basic processes which contribute to increase in population density are mortality and immigration, natality and immigration, mortality and emigration, mortality and immigration. So here the right answer is option B, natality and immigration, because natality is with respect to number of births. If number of births in a population in a place in a given period of time increases, it accounts for increasing in population density. At the same time, immigration, the number of individuals of the same species that have come into the habitat from elsewhere during the time period. Andra bere one habitat dinda mattondo habitat ige onde tharad species yavdo one period of time olagu bandu survive aglikatre, that is immigration. So both of them are the increasing factors for population density. They have the positive effect on population density. So the answer is option B. Then the age structure of population influences population growth, because the age structure of population influences population growth. Andra population growth ಆ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಅದು ಏಜ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ ಆಗ್ಯದ ಅಂತ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಅದ. ಯಾಕೆ ರೀಸನ್ ಹೇಳಬೇಕು, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ರೀಸನ್? ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಯಂಗರ್ ಫೀಮೇಲ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಮೋರ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಪ್ರಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ದ್ಯಾನ್ ಡೂ ಓಲ್ಡರ್ ಫೀಮೇಲ್ಸ್. ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಏಜ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಕೆಪಾಬಿಲಿಟೀಸ್. ದ ಮೋರ್ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಆರ್ ಇಮ್ಯಾಚೋರ್, ದ ಸ್ಲೋವರ್ ದ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗ್ರೋ. ಎ ಶಾರ್ಟರ್ ಜನರೇಷನ್ ಟೈಮ್ results in slower population growth. And the right answer for this question is different age groups have different reproductive capabilities. Because see, the according to ecological point of view, the population is divided into three different age groups: pre-reproductive, reproductive and post-reproductive. Say for example, one the population olaga pre-reproductive age group the individuals jaasti iddara ant itkolona. So bartha bartha they will reach the reproductive age group and they go for reproduction. Illenagta the population nu it will be expanding. ಈಗ ಅದೇ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಒಳಗೆ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಮಾಡೋ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ಸು 50 ಜನ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ಪ್ರೀ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ಸು 10 ಜನ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಣ. ಅಂದರೆ ಪ್ರೀ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ಸದ ಸಂಖ್ಯೆ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ಸದ ಸಂಖ್ಯೆಗಿಂತನೂ ಏನಾಗೈತಿ, ಸಿಕ್ಕಾಪಟ್ಟೆ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಅದ. ಸೊ ಈ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಇದ್ದಾಗ 10 ಜನ ಇನ್ನು ಮುಂದೆ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ಗೆ ಎಂಟರ್ ಆಗ್ತಾರೆ, ದ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್, ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸ್. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಗ್ರೋಥ್ ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ಆ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಇರೋಂಥ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಏಜ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಗಳ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ ಆಗ್ಯದ. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಪ್ರೀ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಏಜ್ ಗ್ರೂಪು ಇನ್ನು ಮುಂದೆ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಎಬಿಲಿಟಿನ ಅಚೀವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ, ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೇನ್ ದ ಕೆಪಾಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಗೋ ದ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್. ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಇದ್ದದ್ದು ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಸೆನೆಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಫೇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಲೂಸಸ್ ದ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಕೆಪಾಬಿಲಿಟಿ. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೈ ದ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಕೆಪಾಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಏಜ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ಫ್ಲೂಯೆನ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಗ್ರೋತ್. ದೆನ್ ದ ಎಬಿಂಗ್ಡನ್ ಟೊರ್ಟೈಸ್ ಇನ್ ಗ್ಯಾಲಪಾಗೋಸ್ ಐಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟಿಂಕ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಎ ಡೆಕೇಡ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಗೋಟ್ಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಐಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಪರೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್. And this is example for competition. When competition is observed between two unrelated species for a common source, one species will be eliminated. Here, the Abingdon tortoise, which is off Galapagos Island, became extinct because of great browsing efficiency of goats. So here we can see the competition relationship between a goat and the Abingdon tortoise. Organisms with high intrinsic growth rates have long generation time, short generation time, no courtship behavior, no carrying capacity. Then question is, what is this intrinsic growth rate? The rate at which population increases. It is the rate at which population increases is called intrinsic growth rate. Organisms with high intrinsic growth rates, enaktava, high intrinsic growth rate is inversely related to generation time. That means organisms with high intrinsic rate, they show short generation times, because the organisms with high intrinsic rate, the intrinsic rate is inversely proportional to generation time, so that the short generation time is shown by high intrinsic growth rates. Gauss competitive exclusion principle. What is the definition? Two closely related species competing for the same resources cannot coexist indefinitely, and competitively inferior one will be eliminated eventually. This is the definition of Gauss competitive exclusion principle. Idakku opposite agi Mark author resource partitioning anta ondu phenomenon anna explain madtana. Warblers, five different types of warblers in a tree, they have survived together. Aida bere bere variety of warblers, they have survived together because they shared the resource. But idakku opposite Gauss competitive exclusion principle yen helutada, two closely related species competing for the same resource, eradu closely related species galu onde resource ge compete maartidre cannot coexist indefinitely. Avu coexist aglikke sadhyilla. Yavudu adrolaga salpa competitive wise, competition wise inferior irutada, adu one divasa eliminate aagtada, and this is result in the elimination of species. Adike competition population interaction valaga negative symbol le tagotivi, because competitively superior one will survive and competitively inferior one is eliminated. So one the species environment dinda eliminate aglikattada andre it is loss of biodiversity. That is why the competition is always resulting in loss of biodiversity. So this is the definition of Gauss competitive exclusion principle. Then kangaroo rats of North American deserts do not need to drink the water because they meet their water requirement through internal fat oxidation when water is a byproduct. So fat oxidation nadadaga kangaroo rat body valaga water byproduct anta produce aagtada. So adakke horagade inda water supply maadkolodu bekagilla. They are able to concentrate urine to minimize water loss. This is also right. Whatever the water is obtained as a byproduct through the fat oxidation, if that water is eliminated along with the urine, again it will be problematic. So that the kangaroo rat instead of producing dilute urine, it produces the concentrated urine. A concentrated urine na produce maadi water loss na minimize maadkotada. They do not have sweat glands. Because sweat glands idre, sweat produce aagtada, even through the sweat, amount of water is lost. So all the above are the adaptations that are found in kangaroo rat. Kangaroo rat North American desert olaga badaklikke idishtu tharaddu physiological adaptations galanna develop madkondada. So with that it is able to survive in the desert. Regarding temperature and osmotic concentration, nearly all plants are, again a direct question, it is a response of the organism to the abiotic factors. All the plants are confirmers because they regulate, they confirm their internal temperature basically by comparing with the environmental conditions. Whatever the ambient temperature is there, according to that, they set the body temperature, hence they are called the confirmers. Then last question. Many tribes living in high altitude of Himalayas have higher WBC count than people living in plains, lower WBC count than people living in the plains, higher RBC count than people living in the plains, lower RBC count than people living in the plains. So here this is adoption related question, where adoption shown by humans living in the high altitude. So as we move to the high altitude, the atmospheric pressure of oxygen decreases or it is low, so that solubility of the oxygen in the blood also decreases. Hence, oxygen carried by the RBCs will be less, so that it cannot fulfill the requirement of oxygen by the blood. So adakke en maartada, oxygen availability ne higher altitude olaga kadime iddaga body requirement anna fulfill maadlikke more number of RBC galu ell jaasti aagtava human body olaga. When more number of RBCs are produced, they carry the more oxygen, so that even though the availability of oxygen is less, it is made possible to supply required amount of oxygen by increasing number of RBCs. So these are the few questions that I wanted to discuss with respect to organisms and populations. So in this part, the questions related to adaptations, questions related to the population attributes, and question related to the age pyramid I have discussed. So after completing all the chapters, I will give some other questions which have already appeared in the competitive exams with respect to the chapter. I hope it is clear. Thank you.